Greetings and welcome to the Introduction to Astronomy. One of the things that I like to do in each of my introductory astronomy classes is to begin the class with the astronomy picture of the day from the NASA website that is apod.nasa.gov/apod. And today's picture for October the 31st of 2020, well, it is titled A Galaxy of Horrors. So what do we see here? Well, we have three movie posters made by NASA highlighting things that are based on real science. So not actual movies, but to kind of putting them together in that sense. And on the left, we look at dark matter. And we know dark matter is a material that makes up the vast majority of the material within the universe. So ordinary matter, that which makes up the stars and the galaxies, is ordinary matter is only about 4% of the material in the universe. And the dark matter is many times this, sometimes 8 or so times the amount of ordinary matter. So the vast majority of the material in the universe is made up of something that we can't see. And sort of like the spider web there, the ordinary matter in the bright section scattered around, and the rest of the material being dark matter. And we have evidence of that through the motions of the galaxies. There has to be far more to account for the gravitational effects that we see, far more material than what we can possibly account for by all the stars and galaxies that are seen. In the middle, we see the galactic graveyard, and this would be about a galaxy that is stopped forming stars long ago. And a graveyard meaning that the stars have just been going through their lives after the first couple of billion years after the Big Bang. If no new stars are forming, then all the stars that are left in the galaxy would be very old red stars. And there'd be stars that evolve would become red supergiant stars and would dominate the light, and the ordinary stars that would be left over after many billions of years like this would be stars that are less than the mass of our sun. So everything would be dominated by the light of these red stars, and lots of dead stars, things like neutron stars and white dwarfs, that would be left behind afterwards. And finally, on the right, we see gamma ray ghouls, which are looking at gamma ray bursts when two dead stars, two neutron stars, collide and give off an intense burst of gamma rays. And it's not the kind of thing you'd want to be anywhere close to. The amount of energy being produced would be many, many times the energy that the sun produces over its entire life. So we could see how much energy is being produced there. And those are things that do go off on a regular basis in our galaxy, but fortunately never close enough to us that they would prove a danger to the Earth. So here for Halloween, we get to see three movie posters created by NASA highlighting some things that actually happen in real life, but putting them into a movie type setting. So that was our picture of the day for October the 31st of 2020. It was titled A Galaxy of Horrors. We'll be back again tomorrow for the next picture, previewed to be Day of the Trifid. So we'll see what that is about tomorrow. And until then, have a great day, everyone, and I will see you in class.